In Microsoft Defender for Office 365, training campaigns are a great way to provide security training to users directly without creating simulated phishing attacks. Creating training campaigns is easy. On the Attack Simulation Training page, select Training, followed by Create New to get started. Type a name for your training campaign, monthly cybersecurity awareness in this case, and an optional description. Then, on the Target Users page, choose which users you want to target with the training. To target specific users, select Add Users. Then, search for users and groups by name or filter by categories, like the suggested groups we provide, tags, cities, countries, departments, and even job titles. In this case, I selected Include All Users in My Organization to create an organization-wide training event. The problem with that is I know the C-suite gets a bit annoyed whenever I send them training, so I'll exclude them. To do that, select Exclude some of the target users from this campaign. While I could use the user selection experience, I do keep their email addresses handy in a CSV file. So I'll select Import to exclude that list of email addresses. After targeting users, the interesting part is choosing the training modules you want in the campaign. While you can link directly to your custom training by selecting Redirect to a custom URL, we recommend selecting from our extensive list of training modules, licensed from our content partners. To get started, select Add Trainings. Then, select a training, like malicious digital QR codes, to see details including a description, available languages, tags, duration, and any campaigns or simulations it's in already. Select Preview to watch the training yourself. If it's training you want to include in the campaign, select Add. Add as many trainings as you like, without overdoing it, of course. And then move on to selecting End User Notifications. While you can use custom notifications, we recommend using our defaults. The default assignment notification isn't configurable, but you can select View to preview it. You can even select different languages, like German, to preview it in those languages. For the reminder notifications, select Delivery Preferences and choose either twice a week or weekly. I'll select weekly reminders for my campaign. Next, configure the schedule for the campaign. There's a lot of flexibility here. You can start the campaign immediately, as soon as you save it, or you can select Schedule This Training Campaign to be launched later and pick a date and time to start it in the future. You can also choose to end the campaign at a specific date and time, or deselect Send Training with an End Date to leave it open-ended. You're almost done. The only thing left to do now is select Submit. Throwing a bunch of training over the wall without the ability to monitor it doesn't make sense. So back on the Training tab, select the campaign you created, Monthly Cybersecurity Awareness in this case, to review its progress. The Report tab gives you a nice overview of the campaign's progress, while the Users tab shows the status of each user you've assigned the training. And last, the Details tab describes the training campaign's configuration. Attack Simulation Training has a few settings that are worthy of a look. On the Attack Simulation Training page, select Settings to configure them. In particular, Training Threshold prevents us from reassigning a training module to a user who has already completed it within a specific number of days. The default is 90 days. Use training campaigns to teach employees topics like security, compliance, privacy, and social engineering risks. To learn more about training campaigns in Defender for Office 365, see our documentation in Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.